All right, Anthony Fasano here from the Engineering Management Institute, and I'm here at the ASCE SEI Structures Congress in Orlando, Florida. I'm here with Mathew Picardal from DCI Engineers out of their Irvine, California office. And Mathew and I did a little coaching with Mathew, and he got really inspired, and he joined ASCE. He's become very active. But Mathew, what I want to ask you about in this episode here is, you've started a YouTube channel. I mean, you've been really inspired to get out there and be kind of a proponent of structural engineering, which is Mathew's discipline. Tell us, like, what made you do that?
Well, for me, you know, I started getting more involved in the hiring process at our firm, you know, hiring interns and the interview process. And a lot of them don't know about what the actual industry is. I think there's a big disconnect between academia and going into designing actual buildings.
Sure.
And for me, it was, well, I know what it is. How come, and you know, the students want to know too. So it's, for me, it was an easy link. Hey, if they want to know what structural engineering is and what the actual day-to-day is and tips to get into the structural engineering industry, it was kind of just a no-brainer for me. Hey, why don't I just put some videos out there, tell them what helped me and advice I would have given myself as I was a young structural engineer. And so that's what kind of inspired me to just, hey, get that information out there, because I don't think there's enough. And
people need it.
Yeah, people need it. And sometimes you go on, you know, as a student, you'll go on and type on the internet what structural engineering is.
Yeah, and there's the resources have to be there. I mean, listen, it's great. You're kind of bridging the gap for people from academia into the real world, and you're trying to give them some of that real world information. But the question I have for you, too, is you're busy, like all engineering professionals, which means, you know, if you're going to do something, you have to make a decision, you have to spend time on it. So you're spending time on this, on doing these YouTube videos and putting some thought and effort into it. So obviously it's something that must be rewarding. How does it feel to be able to do that?
I think it feels really good because, you know, just making a YouTube video, it kind of helps me with it's developing my skills too.
Sure.
As speaking.
Sure.
So coming up with things to say and finding out what my values are, it's kind of like personal development for me too. So it's very rewarding, and putting that content out there for everyone to see. So for me, it's very rewarding in that sense, and helping other people out too. For me, it's if I can help someone out in their career, and just by doing that,
you may help hundreds of people, thousands eventually,
exactly.
if YouTube, you know, gets going on YouTube. So that's great. So what you hear there from Mathew is that by giving back to his community, I mean, he's doing it in many ways, but through the YouTube channel, for example, it's a win for the students that get to watch these videos and learn about the real world of structural engineering, but it's also a win for Mathew in that he's developing his communication skills, he's putting some pressure on himself, he's broadening his horizons, he's making himself uncomfortable, and it's really a win-win. So Mathew, thanks again for sharing that with us in this video episode, and I wish you the best of luck in continuing to do it.
Thanks.
PPI is a proud sponsor of the Engineering Management Institute. Thinking about advancing in your career by taking your FE, PE, or SE exam? Visit ppi2pass.com to find everything you need to start preparing today.